exhibitions so far this season. You lost New Mexico, but you played number three DU right down to the wire. Are you guys feeling pretty good before you start?
Definitely. It's just getting the kinks out, you know, from the summer, and definitely introducing some new players, some new styles. Coach Doyle leaving, it's definitely hard to fill that role, but we're doing it well, and we're just trying to new things. So
honored by the fact that you're preseason All-WAC?
Yeah, I mean, it's a very amazing accomplishment for me personally, but it's not mine to share alone. You know, it's a team effort. I don't score anything without them, so just because my name's out there doesn't really mean anything to me other than the fact that our team is getting better and is going to do really well this year.
Back to the All-WAC team. You got three players on that All-WAC team. Is this indicative? I mean, that's the most of any team in the WAC. Does that say something that people are watching Air Force soccer?
Definitely. I think they understand that we have some great players on this team, and just because we're a military service academy doesn't mean that great players can't come to it.
Two exhibitions under your belt now. What did you learn from those two games that can help you this season?
The most is probably leading my teammates. Going through the struggle, you know, getting the jitters out of those first two exhibition games will definitely, you know, help me show that confidence to my teammates that they'll need to, you know, play calmly and, you know, get the win.
The good thing is those are two great teams we played. New Mexico, we dropped that 1-3-1, but we got to see a lot of players. Unfortunately, we got three players injured. Two of them are back. Zane Moxley, ACL, so he's out for the season. Denver, tie, they were ranked high. That was last year's ranking. But I thought we played well. We got our first goal. We just got to learn how to keep that first goal and not let them score. So I thought it was pretty good.
Kind of an honor for you and two of your teammates. The most players represented by one team on the All-WAC preseason team. How does it feel?
Definitely. It feels good. Coming off a good last year, that gives us a lot of promise to do well this season and head into the tournament and finally reach that goal of winning the championship. So, yeah.
Is this you? I mean, it seems to me like you have two really good teams coming in for this opening weekend. Did you plan it that way?
No, you do your scheduling 2 years out. However, Florida Gulf Coast, 23rd in the country, they have a guy that scored 22 goals last year. That's probably 60% that most Division I teams scored. So, are we going to mark him? Yeah, we're going to mark him. But we're going to concentrate on our play. At the beginning of the season, you really want to focus on what your team's doing well, minimize your errors, and playing at home is the biggest advantage we got.
Pack the house on Friday. Have you told your whole squadron you're going to have some cadets down here?
Oh, yeah. There's been numerous announcements, a couple emails sent out. We're definitely looking forward to it. Should get a lot of fans. And, yeah, the team is very excited, so looking forward to it.
Tell me, Missouri State coming down, pack the house. Tell me how excited the cadets are for this.
Oh, I mean, speaking for my squadron only, which Johnny Sims is also in, and they're pumped up. There's a lot of support already. I know I've got friends on the dance team, Wings of Blue, and they're all coming out. So really awesome to get all their support. So,
how much does that help you? Because you're going to have a lot of home games early on in this season. How much does it help you to get the crowd support?
It's awesome, in my opinion. You can really build off that. And having eight games to start the season at home, like for us, that's huge. Or 2 years ago when we played Army, I know it was awesome as a freshman, getting them, everybody out excited, and then we didn't play at home for like 2 weeks after that. So this is going to be really something I haven't seen before, and I'm looking forward to, because the crowd energy always makes games easier.
Have you talked about team goals for the season at all? You picked fourth.
Yeah, funny you mentioned that. So preseason ends, we play the Denver match, we come in after that, and we set our goals. And the guys are still hungry from last year's conference play. We left something on the table. They want it, but it takes a lot of work to get there. I know every team, 11 of them, want the same thing. But the boys are focused, and I think you'll see a good showing Friday night.